Ladies and gentlemen, please stand to welcome the Columbia College graduating class of 2018. Ladies and gentlemen, please join us in welcoming our distinguished Columbia College alumni. Finally, please welcome to the stage our esteemed faculty and the officiants for this morning's ceremony. Thank you.
Please be seated. President Bollinger, on behalf of the Dean, the faculty, and the Columbia College class of 2018, I respectfully ask your permission to begin these class day exercises. Thank you. And good morning, Columbia College. President Bollinger, Vice President Madigan, Dean Valentini, Ms. Gardner, distinguished faculty, esteemed alumni, and guests, I am proud to recognize the members of the class of 2018 and mark their shared and individual accomplishments in these class day exercises. At this time, I would like to invite John Avendano, President of the Columbia College class of 2018, to the podium.
Thank you, Matthew. And good morning to President Bollinger, Dean Valentini, Ms. Gardner, to the faculty, to our friends and families, and the amazing class of 2018. You know, they say to never judge a book by its cover. And I'm ashamed to admit, 4 years ago, that's exactly what I did. Before I'd arrived at Columbia, I'd collected mental snapshots of this place and created an impression of what it was like, and I judged it by its cover. I thought I was coming into this big city, metropolitan campus where I'd feel isolated, and every man for himself, dog-eat-dog bullpen where only the academic elite survive. I thought my toughest challenge would be making friends, and finding that sense of community I'd enjoyed so much during my sheltered high school existence. I also thought that as a fencing recruit, I'd be an outcast anyway, because let's face it, who cares about fencing? Well, as it turns out, I was wrong on all fronts. There's no question the academic standards are elevated and the students driven. But what I wasn't expecting is that our passionate drive to be our best would actually bring us together in this environment rather than splitting us apart. That will forever stand as the biggest lesson I learned here at Columbia. And for that lesson, I thank all of you, the graduating class of 2018. I knew the curriculum would be tough and the competition fierce, but what I didn't know is that those same individuals who challenged me to prove my academic mettle in the classrooms and lecture halls every day would also challenge me to ditch a study session the day before an exam and hop on that one train to Times Square to blow off steam, to be young and impulsive, to just be. I knew I wanted to spread my wings and explore other sides of myself and really reap all the benefits of being at a place like Columbia, but I didn't know it would come so holistically and from all directions. There isn't a group here I can't join. There isn't a table I can't sit at. There isn't a rally I can't support or oppose based on my own personal choice. There isn't a place I don't feel I belong. I knew the school was known for its outspokenness, for its protests of historic proportions, and for its students' fierce determination to stand up for what they believe in, but I didn't know that those same brilliant minds who utilize their freedom of expression so eloquently to stand up to their adversaries could later sit at a table with those same adversaries and engage in respectful and profoundly insightful discourse for the benefit of all. If Columbia's social culture could be duplicated in the real world, we would be better off as a society. Now, hold on. I'm not saying we're perfect and that we don't have our differences. I'm saying that we have created a place where our differences are front and center, yet we still find a way to remember why we're all here, and we push ourselves and each other to focus on the lesson to be learned. I knew there'd be partying. I mean, we go to college in New York City. but I didn't know that the reference room in Butler Library is actually Columbia's hottest nightclub. Because no matter how many Wednesdays we might have gone to senior night or how many Saturdays we might have ended up at Cannon's, RIP, our late night conversations never turned frivolous for long. We discuss our course content out of a genuine interest in it, not an obligation, and our shared passion for each of our unique pursuits binds us together. I could list 1,000 memories that I'm sure you can all relate to, like how these lawns in front of Butler are always closed, or how the marching band can get super rowdy on Orgo night, or how our football team can pull off the most incredible win at homecoming our senior year I ever could have seen. Or how beautiful our tree-lit college walk looks on a snowy night. But there's a depth to our bond that goes beyond these precious and fleeting images. The most impactful memory that I know will never leave any of us is the influence that we have all had on each other's experiences here. I want to thank each and every one of you for letting me into all of your lives and giving me this platform to express just how much this experience has changed me. I know many of you can relate because after speaking with so many of you, you've expressed the exact same sentiment to me. As we all go our separate ways, never again will we be so fortunate to have had the kinds of experiences that we had while we were here. And after we're gone, well, Columbia will continue to be a beacon in the ongoing quest towards equality and fairness in every domain. The graduate student workers of Columbia will continue to fight until they receive the recognition. Until they receive the recognition they deserve. And marginalized groups on campus will make sure their voices are heard for decades to come. Even though we won't be living it anymore, we must not ever lose sight of that important part of ourselves that we created here because of each other. It's easy to lose sight of things when they're no longer in front of us anymore. Out of sight, out of mind. I know it's cliche for me to keep on saying thank you, but my gratitude is the predominant emotion swirling inside of me right now. So to all the parents and grandparents and family members, to the administrative staff, to our professors, our coaches, and to everyone in this audience who has helped us get to where we are today, let's give them a big round of applause. And I'll also say this, I look at the cover in a completely different way now that I've read the whole book, and I couldn't be luckier to have been so wrong. Class of 2018, we inspired each other, we influenced each other, we challenged each other, we supported each other, we amused each other, we loved each other, and we molded each other into the best versions of ourselves. And we will go out into this world and continue to make each other and Columbia forever proud. To close, I'd like to use a few words from the Broadway musical Hamilton. Look around. Look around at how lucky we are to be alive right now. The day is ours, class of 2018. Now let's go out and live meaningful and impactful lives. It's been an honor. Thank you. Oh, sorry, I gotta take a selfie. All right. Now I'm thrilled to introduce our keynote speaker, Dee Dee Gardner. She's the first female producer to win 2 Academy Awards for Best Picture, and is co-president of Brad Pitt's production company, Plan B, entertainment. Ms. Gardner, a Columbia College comparative literature and English major, currently serves on the Columbia College Board of Visitors. She has spoken about her career to alumni, faculty, parents, and students at both regional and campus events, and in 2012 received a John Jay Award for Distinguished Professional Achievement at the annual John Jay Awards dinner. After graduating from Columbia College, she worked as a location scout in New York City and went on to take positions at Innovative Artists and the William Morris Agency. Before her current role at Plan B, she served as Executive Vice President of Production at Paramount Pictures. Throughout her career, she has produced many Academy Award-nominated films, including The Big Short, Selma, The Tree of Life, Moonlight, and 12 Years a Slave, the latter two, which earned her the award for Best Picture. Currently, she is in pre- and post-production on several films, is exploring new film endeavors such as with auteurs such as Andrew Dominik, Adam McKay, and James Gray, and is developing series projects with Netflix, Amazon, HBO, and FX. Please join me in welcoming five-time Academy Award nominee and two-time Academy Award winner, Dee Dee Gardner.
Good morning, Columbia. Okay. thank you. Thank you very much. Where'd you go? All right. Memo, I was not class president, so I have not memorized my speech. Apology number one. Thank you for being here and for welcoming me here. Thank you for asking me to be here. Welcome to all the families and friends of the graduating class of 2018. okay, I'm gonna try this. You're here. Well done. Well done. Well done. You've worked really tirelessly to arrive at this moment, and I am very proud for you. Not of, but for. Much more miraculously, I am here. And if I ever suspected that my choice to live behind the camera were random, I can now with utter confidence be assured of one very deliberate choice in my life. Because this is super terrifying. Still, it's very meaningful to me to be here. Columbia is where I first reckoned with the truth, my own, first and foremost, and that of those around me, both known and unknown, the truths that I detected in the texts that moved me, truth-telling as a physics by which to live. Columbia is where I learned the value of rigorous thinking. It is where I began to listen. And it is this last muscle, that of ever listening, that I want to talk about. And I have come to believe with all of my heart that in order to really listen to another human being, you must first be able to listen to yourself. And in order to do that, you have to speak first. You must engage in the mighty tussle of constant admission and renewed vulnerability. In short, you must honor and utter and behold that which you fear. So we're gonna do this a little differently than perhaps is common. Indulge me, please, if you will, it won't take long. And I do have a point, and if you let me down, at least there was an intention, know that. But it does require all of your participation in those tents and all of you guys. It all requires participation, it turns out. So a handful of weeks ago, I sent an email to the entire graduating class asking them what they most feared and imploring them to answer not how they thought they should, but as they really felt on the inside, the place where we make it all up as we go. I want to read you some of those answers, and I ask that you, everyone else here, that you listen carefully, and you'll understand why in a minute. You wrote, being afraid of not making a difference, of not bettering the lives of those around you, of leaving the world not having contributed enough, of not making a positive or meaningful impact, being afraid of being more concerned with money than with passion, of selling out, being afraid of losing one's identity once becoming a parent, of not living up to the expectations of one's chosen faith, of wasting time, of squandering this brief lap we are given, of not following through on all the ideas and desires so vividly ahum inside you right now, of lovelessness, of not experiencing unconditional love, of not learning to love without fear, of heartbreak, of dying having left no legacy, of dying believing you've only ever achieved the average, being afraid of incompetence, being afraid of the strife and conflict and devastation being wrought all around us, to our bodies, to our minds, to our planet, of the epic cosmic consequences of racism, of bigotry, of misogyny, of hatred, of violence, of unchecked power and unrelenting greed, of not being able to provide for your families, of causing harm, of losing compassion, of losing your innocence, your sense of curiosity, of growing disillusioned, your idealism waning, of lacking courage, of average being good enough, of complacency, of complicity, of meaningful work not being sufficiently remunerative to survive, of being exposed, that of a hollow life and that of a hollow heart, of having peaked, of living out your days with your greatest accomplishment behind you, of never stopping, of never being struck with awe until it is too late, of unemployment, of being unable to support yourself, of being out of control, of maintaining your sobriety, the multitude of ways in which one holds fast, slipping through your fingers, of dying, of death, of it all being over before having sat inside one's dream, of losing a loved one or loved ones, of bearing witness to pain and loss, being endured just next to you but light years too far to share, of living a life of should and not wish, of being honest, honest about your past, about your grief, grief as your bedfellow, about your sources of sadness, of ending up unhappy, of not finding true happiness or not recognizing one's own unhappiness until it is far, far too late to do something about it, of not being given a second chance and a third and a fourth and a fifth, of not being extraordinary, of being mediocre, of making unremarkable work and tread, of not changing the world, of not making a difference, of living another's definition of you, of rejection, of living for a resume's accumulation and allure, of mental illness, yours, a family member's, a friend's, of deportation, of living the bubble of Colombia in these last 4 years, of discovering this time and the relationships you've forged here fleeting, moving into the column of memory, of hurting those you love, of the passage of time, of falling short of your dreams and expectations, ebbing resilience, not living up to your potential, or worse, not even knowing when you have let go, of loneliness, of being alone, of dying alone, of growing old alone, of disappointing your family, those who have put faith in you, of violating this faith, of yourselves, of trusting yourselves, of never really knowing your true self, being unable to place yourself, in essence, of disappointing yourself, not being proud of your work, worthy of your ambitions, being afraid of change, and being afraid to change, of the unknown, of uncertainty, of failure. In your own eyes, in that of your family's eyes, all of your hard work amounting to nothing or not enough of something, and of having regrets that there will come a time when you will look back and think, I should have done this, or I should have said that. What if I could have done better? I didn't understand my purpose. I didn't venture beyond my comfort zone. I lived unexamined. I took no risks. I do not look fondly upon myself, of wondering and wondering and wondering what if. These are your fears. Watch, though. Will everyone for whom anything I just said rings true, will you raise your hand? So they're fears that belong to all of us. They are all of ours. And I give this commonality to you as your first state of awareness as graduates, because I have lived long enough to know that it is from this understanding that anything is possible. It is from here you must measure yourself. It is from this awareness you must practice and practice and practice being human above all else. It is from here that kindness and empathy are born and take flight. It is from here that false certainty sputters, because conviction infused with your experience alone is a weapon and false armor and deeply harmful. It is from here the heart-mind begins to turn and the revolutions begin. It is from this place of haunting recognition, despite all evidence to the contrary, that we can see our fractured, gasping selves in others. And from here that we can begin to commit to the value of story, of all the stories. Your story is your legacy, no matter when or how or if it gets told. But its honest articulation is on you. Briefly, as requested, I will not tell you that you will learn from mistakes and therefore that regrets are good, though the learning part is true. Regrets are awful and very painful, but they are not clever unless you hide them. With some air and some light, you can turn them into talismans for your shelf. Instead of growing specters under your skin, you can unghost them with words. I'm not going to tell you not to be afraid, because you will be, dozens of times. I have been more afraid in the last 18 months of my life than any time prior, but I've also been more alert, and I've also been more alive. On the contrary, I am saying, listen for your fears. Strive to detect your tremble, and even more so, work so hard to see it mercilessly at play in everyone around you, in your family, in your friends, in your lovers, in your neighbors, in all the strangers coursing their days next to you. Presume very little in your life, but of this I am sure, if they are human, if they breathe and churn and rage and dance and stomp and mourn and honor, know that they too are walking this mad human experiment, and know that they too are scared. No matter how alien this may seem to you, I believe it is here you will find the kindest reflection, and in this gleam, your leap. I wish you beautiful lives.
Thank you, Ms. Gardner, for your thoughtful message of shared humanity. I really appreciated it. I'm Kristen Crom, Dean of Undergraduate Student Life, and now we are turning our attention to a few graduates who, like Ms. Gardner, have inspired and uplifted our community during their time here. In each class, there are students who distinguish themselves and their school through superior academic accomplishments and service to others. Over the past few weeks, we have recognized students who have been particularly gracious with their time and talents. Their efforts have enhanced Columbia in so many ways. At this time, I ask those students who received academic or athletic awards and prizes, were selected as senior marshals, were honored with a graduation cord, or were recognized at the Leadership and Excellence Award Ceremony or other celebrations to please stand. It's a beautiful sea of faces out there. We applaud your commitments and abilities and are grateful for your contributions. I am fortunate to have known and worked alongside so many of you. It is also a great honor for me to present our first Class Day Award, the Charles M. Rolker Prize, to Nicole Alleycock, whose classmates have deemed her worthy. Who whose classmates have deemed her worthy of special distinction for scholarship, participation in student activities, preeminence in athletics, or any combination of these. Nicole is being recognized for her leadership within the Columbia College Student Council. She began a policy initiative 3 years ago to better align the Global Core with its mission. She has worked with administrators and faculty members on the curriculum, adjusting class syllabi, and making seminars a part of the requirement. Never one to accept an answer of no or not yet, she continually rethought ways to advocate for her goals. On a personal note, I will miss Nicole's persistence, her ability to frame ideas in terms of outcomes, and her interest in working collaboratively to enhance the Columbia College student experience. Please join us in congratulating Nicole. I'd now like to invite Lisa Holaba, Dean of Academic Planning and Administration, to present the recipients of this year's academic awards.
Thank you, Kristen. On behalf of the faculty, it is now my honor to present four awards for academic achievement: the Albert Asher Green Memorial Prize, the David B. Truman Alumni Award, and the honors of salutatorian and valedictorian. The Albert Asher Green Memorial Prize was established by Mr. and Mrs. Asher Green in memory of their son, Albert Asher Green, class of 1914. The prize is awarded to the senior who has been a student in good standing in the college and who has made the best record of scholarship by earning the highest GPA in the graduating class. The recipient this year is Jia Wan. Throughout her time at Columbia, Jia has competed on a robotics team in Hong Kong, participated in Columbia's math undergraduate summer research program, presented at the poster session of a joint meeting of the Mathematical Association of America and the American Mathematical Society, and served as a teaching assistant for classes in computer science and operations research. Having majored in applied mathematics, Jia will continue her studies after graduation in Columbia's master's program in computer science, where she plans to pursue her research interests in graph theory and theoretical computer science. Congratulations, Jia. The David B. Truman Alumni Award was established to honor David B. Truman, former dean of the college, and is given to the Columbia College student who has made the most distinguished contribution to the academic affairs of the college. This year's recipient is Adam Joseph Elkadem. Adam describes himself as a proud Houstonian. In his time at Columbia, Adam has been a longstanding member of the Student Council's Academic Awards Committee, who select the annual faculty winners of the Trilling Award for Scholarship and the Van Doren Award for Teaching, and he has served as the president of the Fernald Film Club. Having majored in both art history and political science, he plans after graduation to attend law school and to offer legal assistance to those who may be least able to afford it, giving them access to the protection of the law. Congratulations, Adam. I am now pleased to recognize the salutatorian for the class of 2018, Hannah Bender. Faculty members describe Hannah as an incredibly impressive researcher and an exceptional student with the highest gifts of intellect and character. Hannah has conducted research on the cellular process of ferroptosis, served as a teaching assistant for courses on cellular and molecular immunology, and was inducted into this year's Junior Phi Beta Kappa. Active in our community, she's been a lead student leader in the Columbia Outdoor Orientation Program, volunteered in the School of Public Health's program called A Friend for Rachel, and been an active member of Sigma Delta Tau sorority. Her interests have also taken her beyond college walk, performing service in Israel, Argentina, and Poland with Columbia Hillel, helping in a free clinic in Honduras with Global Brigades, and studying religious pluralism in India with the Kraft Global Fellow Program. Congratulations, Hannah. I am now pleased to recognize the valedictorian for the class of 2018, Sam Goldberg. Faculty members describe Sam as a motivated young woman with a wide spectrum of knowledge and outreach experience, and a razor-sharp creative thinker with a profound sense of duty towards social justice. Sam has conducted research on the impacts of immigration enforcement on farm workers in New York State, has been named a Global Fellow in Sustainable Development, and was inducted into this year's Junior Phi Beta Kappa. Outside of the classroom, she has worked as an activity specialist in City Growers, a nonprofit organization where she teaches middle school-aged youths about urban agriculture. After graduation, Sam will be conducting research on climate change resilience and urban agriculture at the NASA Goddard Institute for Space Studies. Please help me congratulate Sam and welcome her to the podium.
Thank you, Dean Holaba. This is going to blow away. My roommates and I like to play a game called Concept. The premise is simple. You allow yourself to be struck with inspiration and then declare, concept. Most of the time, our concepts are absurd and inconsequential. Concept, a person who thinks their laptop is a flip phone and walks around speaking into the oversized apparatus. Occasionally, though, the game serves as an outlet for sardonic commentary on an imperfect world. Concept, an Earth with a stable climate. A silly game, to be sure, but Concept is also, in many ways, a distillation of what my time at Columbia has been. An opportunity to imagine new worlds with my peers. While studying sustainable development, I have honed a critical lens called systems thinking. This means breaking down worlds into their component parts and assessing whether each part contributes to the regeneration of the system or its deterioration. A classic example of regeneration can be found in forest growth and decay. Forests contain sophisticated mechanisms for cycling resources internally, but sometimes humans will have goals that do not align with these natural cycles, and our attempts to override these systems can be quite destructive to the forests themselves. Similar tensions exist in our social systems. Societies have overarching goals. At Columbia, one of the major goals of the system is knowledge production. But members within a society also experience competing concerns. Demands related to our mental and physical security constantly reroute our energies away from these overarching goals. As I reflect on my time on this campus, I have wondered how effective is the system at Columbia? Does the university make space for addressing these competing concerns that accompany our intellectual journeys and allow for our regeneration? My Columbia experience has been riddled with discord between the university's timelines for knowledge production and my own erratic will to learn while struggling with anxiety and depression. There were painful moments when I did not feel supported by this institution, and when I did not have the energy to take intellectual risks. Thank you. I have been fortunate enough, though, to find stabilizing forces in the smaller scale communities that I belong to here. Among the friends who asked, "How can I support you?" as commonly as someone might say hello, and among the professors and TAs who regularly checked in, I'm so grateful to all of you. Environmental preservationists will often make the argument that nature must be removed from human contact in order to avoid destruction. This is a fallacy that overlooks other workable solutions where all members of the system mutually benefit from their interactions. It is harmful to our community and the goal of learning when Columbia's institutional rhythms do not accommodate its students' needs for mental and physical security. As I look out into the faces of the class of 2018, though, I am hopeful because I see 4 years' worth of conviction in another version of Columbia. I see the students who are fighting for campus-wide food security and access to 24/7 health services. I see student workers and their allies exercising their right to form a union. President Bollinger and Provost Coatsworth, I urge you to heed their voices and bargain now. The individuals on the front lines of these and similar efforts, I want to say thank you. Thank you for your labor and for loving this community so radically that you have dared to change it. Of course, Columbia is a reflection of the world order in which it is embedded. So as I prepare to leave this campus, my thoughts also graze the question, what does a regenerative world look like beyond this institution? The most that I can say is that this world does not coexist with white supremacy. It does not coexist with patriarchy. It does not coexist with any systems of oppression. Beyond that, I do not have the answer to this question, because that answer must be a collaborative one, and the solution must foreground the voices of oppressed people. I think the more... productive question I might ask is, how do I responsibly support these efforts to fashion another world? Those treasured world-building conversations I have shared with my peers at Columbia have taught me that this work requires a deep commitment to listening, giving space, holding yourself and your communities accountable, trusting others' experiences, especially those to which you cannot relate, and being gentle with yourself and those that you love. This work is messy and often entails uncomfortable reckonings with different and complicated forms of privilege. But to quote the wisdom of Audre Lorde, our persistence, our persistence in examining the tensions within diversity encourages growth toward our common goal. Class of 2018, even though we will disperse from this campus soon, I hope we can all continue working toward the goal of a more regenerative world together. Thank you. would now like to call forward Michael Berenger, graduate of the Columbia class of 1989 and current president of the Columbia College Alumni Association.
Thank you, Sam. What beautiful and heartfelt words. Everyone, Sam, done. It's a horrific act to follow. Thank you. It's great. On behalf of the more than 50,000 alumni of Columbia College, I welcome students, parents, faculty, and friends here today. Congratulations, Columbia class of 2018. Today, we honor your hard work, your commitment, all that has allowed you to reach today's milestone. And as alumni, we are proud and impressed by the heights you've reached at Columbia, and so thrilled that you'll join us in this next and lifelong phase as a Columbian. You may have graduated from Columbia College, but your connection to the school and its community has not ended. As you join the ranks of former students before you, so much of your future, your choices, your experiences will have you reflecting upon your time here, your lessons both inside and outside of the classroom, and they'll continue to bear fruits in ways you just can't even foresee yet. From the core curriculum to my favorite jumbo slices at Coronet, from College Walk to the streets of this great city, these experiences have connected generations of Columbians before you, and they'll continue to do so after today. As an undergraduate here, I was a member of a fraternity, Phi Gamma Delta. Hey, guys. We were established over 150 years ago, and we had a motto, not for college days alone. And as a student, I heard those words, but it's really only as an alumni that I came to appreciate their subtle wisdom. You may think the friendships and relationships you have here today with your classmates, your faculty and administrators, you may think that's time-bound to this campus. I assure you they are not. They will grow and they will strengthen over the years. They will last you a lifetime, just as mine have. And they will expand to include not just those you knew during your time here on campus, but to the entire alumni community which you now join. The Columbia College Alumni Association is your doorway to reunite you with those classmates, connect you to fellow alumni, and to connect you with professors with whom you still have so much to share. We look forward to having you join the thousands of engaged alumni worldwide. And just as you shaped the college during your 4 years on campus, we know that you'll continue to contribute to our dynamic community through your energy, your passion, and your relentless pursuit of excellence. So, this week, as graduates, you'll undoubtedly receive much advice from commencement speakers and other well-wishers. They'll range from profound statements to follow your dreams, and more practical advice to floss daily, wear sunscreen. Indulge me, please, by letting me offer you these words. Enjoy the moment. Remember your classmates. You have the gift of this incredible social and professional network of Columbians can enrich your life. Take advantage of it. As alumni, stay engaged. Stay involved. Pay it forward. Interview prospective students. Join the Odyssey Mentoring Program. Come back for homecoming. We're going to win more. I promise. Participate in your reunions. Join a regional Columbia club. Gather with your fellow Columbians. Share your newfound knowledge with the faculty. There are so many ways to stay connected as alumni. I hope you find the right one for you. Your chapter is Columbia Undergraduates? Yes, that ends today. But the novel that is your Columbia experience is yet to be written. And we so look forward to seeing what is to come. So once again, congratulations to the great class of 2018. It is now my great honor to present three awards on behalf of the Columbia College Alumni Association. The Alumni Prize is awarded to a return visitor, Nicole Hollycock, who's been judged by her classmates to be the most faithful and deserving student. So let me reintroduce Nicole. Nicole is being recognized for her service as Vice President for Policy on the Columbia College Student Council and co-chair of the Mental Health Task Force. This past year, she focused on establishing a better financial support system for students during the summer and for student body-wide mental health trainings. In her 4 years on the council, she's advocated for increasing first-generation access to the Writing Center, open course evaluations, a faculty student mentorship program, and a travel fund for students and travel groups. Congratulations, Nicole. The Robert Lincoln Carey Memorial Prize is awarded to Emily Hannah Levine, who, through a combination of leadership qualities, best exemplifies the ideals which Robert Lincoln Carey sought to engender in the students of Columbia College. Emily brings positivity and energy to everything she does to fulfill her passion for strengthening the Columbia community. She served as the Vice President for the Class of 2018, Philanthropy Chair for Columbia College Student Ambassadors, and the Events Vice Chair for the Senior Fund. She selflessly gave her time and effort to ensure that the Columbia community was a more tightly knit and supportive environment than when she found it. And she will carry her contagious passion for education with her after she graduates and she becomes a middle school teacher in Brooklyn. Congratulations, Emily. That is Emily's dad, in case you... The Alumni Association Achievement Award is given to Danny Yao Lee, Danny is judged to be the most outstanding in qualities of mind, character, and service to the college. Danny served as a student representative on Columbia's Committee for the Core Curriculum, and he was a member of the University Judicial Board. As an instructor, Danny taught weekly philosophy and debate classes at Rikers Island Correctional Facility. In addition, he served as chair of New York Advocacy, leading the organization's fight for felon enfranchisement and bail reform. Congratulations, Danny. Good job. Before I close, I'd like to give a word of thanks for your support of the senior class gift. The tradition of the Senior Fund at Columbia gives each class the opportunity to give back to future students. And the class of 2018 has had great success this year, attributable most notably to the incredible matching challenge from our own Dean Valentini. Who personally matched each gift with his own gift in honor of you, $20.18, emphasizing the value of each and every participant. Your hard work and generosity has paid off. Results are still being tabulated, but the Senior Fund recently reached 466 donors, a 17% increase in donors from last year and surpassing total dollars raised. None of this would have been possible without the tireless energy and effort of co-chairs Maya Ho and Sarah Sakowitz and the 17 members of the Senior Fund Executive Committee. Can I ask them all to please stand so we may thank you for your dedication this year? Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, if I could ask you to please direct your attention to the screens for a brief video from our dean. Thank you.
Dear Columbia College class of 2018, from the moment I first spoke to you at convocation to today, as you prepare to begin your journey beyond College Walk, it has been exciting to watch you explore and discover, be it in classes or internships, on campus or abroad, through the arts or athletics, through entrepreneurial endeavors or research. I have listened as you shared ideas and watched as you took advantage of the many opportunities within your reach. Through it all, you've used your beginner's mind. You've made friends with whom you've watched the tree lighting on College Walk, debated the meaning of Lit Hum readings in Butler, and had snowball fights on low steps. You have studied Homer and Toni Morrison, science and writing, music and art. As you prepare for the next stage of your journey, never forget that your future path will be forever paved with Pantone 292. You are individuals with your own personal experience and memories. But together, you are the great Columbia College class of 2018. Good morning. President Bollinger, trustees of the university, Vice President Madigan, faculty colleagues, Mr. Berenger, alumni in the parade of classes, family and friends, welcome again to Columbia College Class Day. And to you, the 1,203 members of the class of 2018, congratulations. That video that you just saw was made by Hui Ha, a first-year student in engineering. The music was composed by Simon Cohen, a first-year Columbia College student. Many of you will remember convocation. As today, your families were here with you. President Bollinger was here, as were many Columbia College faculty dressed in the same academic regalia you see us wearing today. That was exactly 1,361 days ago, for those of you who experienced Convocation 2014. I said to you at Convocation 2014 that what you would do each of those days would define your Columbia College experience and bring you here to Class Day. Each of you brought a special personal story, a story of the path by which you arrived here. You were then at the beginning of your Columbia College journey. Everything you have done during your time here has been part of that journey. Your discussions in the classroom, your interactions with faculty and fellow students, and your co-curricular activities all will shape your personal and professional lives in the years to come. I am sure you have had days of jubilation, perhaps not as great as today, but still days of triumph. But I am also sure you have experienced setbacks and you have had to pivot in response to those setbacks. And you have found that the path may not always be straight and predictable, but that it can lead to success in ways that, though not at all predictable, are no less satisfying. During these days at Columbia College, you not only gained knowledge, but also developed critical thinking and research abilities, honed your written and oral communication skills, improved your quantitative information and technological literacy, engaged in teamwork and collaboration, expanded your creativity and innovation, took on civic and individual responsibility, participated in community engagement and inclusion, built global awareness, and encouraged all of us to foster a sense of wellness and resilience. In short, you developed your core competencies even before you knew that phrase or could name its components, as I just did. While the narrative of my Columbia College journey was introduced to you only a month ago, you were on your very own individual Columbia College journey from the moment you arrived here without realizing it. What has changed is the self-awareness of that journey, a self-awareness that you will have many years to benefit from. The word journey derives from the Latin diurnus, meaning day by day or daily. There will be a lot more days than the 1,361 that you have spent at Columbia as a student. According to the actuaries at the Social Security Administration, you can expect about 23,000 additional days, 62 years in your journey. And though you are graduating, it is still your Columbia College journey, because Columbia College is now a fundamental part of you, and your experience here will forever influence your path. The road goes on, paved with Pantone 292, and all that that color represents. So you still have lots of time to focus on your core competencies and lots of reason to do so, because pretty much every day you will have an opportunity to develop them and a reason to develop them. I certainly have in the 2,448 days that I have been Dean of Columbia College. Being Dean has given me an awareness of those core competencies, an opportunity every day to develop them further, and a need every day to do so. Jubilation derives from the Latin as well and refers to a very vocal kind of joy, with wild and loud shouting of great enthusiasm. Loud shouting I am certain I'm going to hear at this ceremony today. Class day is a day on which I experience jubilation as well, though my shouting is not as loud as yours. Decorum requires that as dean I be a little more subdued, except during snowball fights. But it is a singular day for me as it is for you, perhaps the most significant day in the year for me as dean. Every day can't be like this one. Every day can't be cause for loud shouting of great joy. But every day can be a source of satisfaction and fulfillment and meaning. You will notice I did not say happiness. I did not, because happiness is not the objective, the object to pursue. You know that, and you know what is to be pursued, because it's part of the core curriculum experience of every student. It is eudaimonia. Eudaimonia, indeed. Eudaimonia is to be found when you plot your own trajectory, when you build on what you have learned here to be active and engaged citizens, responsible and valuable members of the many communities, personal and professional, large and small, of which you will be part. Eudaimonia means much more than simply faring well or being successful, the outcomes with which happiness is associated. Eudaimonia is the essence of my Columbia College journey, a personal, individual, unique path to flourishing, substance, and meaning in life. Many things will interfere with, even preclude, the simple thing called happiness, events you can't influence and people you can't persuade. But the eudaimonia of your journey is indeed yours, so focus on it. One former student who has done just that is Dee Dee Gardner, Columbia College class of 1990. Dee Dee's journey has taken her from being a reader of narratives in the classrooms of literature humanities to a creator of narratives in the studios of Hollywood. Powerful narratives that you have listened to and watched in 12 Years a Slave and Moonlight and The Tree of Life and The Big Short. These stories reflect on the complex and imperfect human experience, an exercise Dee Dee continued in preparation for today when she asked all of you, of what and whom are you afraid? She was not anticipating a particular answer, as she has already said, not trying to get you to give the right answer, but rather the most personal answer you could summon and share. We admitted you to Columbia College based on our belief that you were the applicants who could best profit from and contribute to the experience of Columbia College. I hope you have profited from your experience. I know you have contributed to it in classrooms, athletic arenas, laboratories, resonance halls, and even on Low Beach. For all of that, I thank you. All of us in Columbia College, thank you. Tomorrow at commencement, you will relinquish your title of current student and take on the new title of former student and become members of the Columbia College Alumni Association. We hope you will continue to profit from and contribute to the lives of other Columbians, to your own classmates, to other alumni who have preceded you, to the students who will come after you. Congratulations to all of you, to your families, to your professors, to your coaches, to your advisors, to your mentors. Class of 2018, you are the greatest class ever. And now I want to take a moment to ask you to join with me in congratulating and thanking someone who isn't a graduate today, but who is very important to us today, David Madigan, Vice President of Arts and Sciences, who is ending his term as Vice President, returning to the faculty as a Professor of Statistics. David, would you please stand? Thank you. David has been a great university partner in this exceptional and singular experience called Columbia College, and I am individually deeply grateful for that partnership. He will remain on the faculty of the Department of Statistics, and I think we will see him on this stage again because he is the parent of three Columbia College students, two of whom have yet to graduate but will in the near future. Thank you, David. I now have the pleasure of introducing Lee C. Bollinger. President Bollinger became Columbia University's 19th president in 2002 and is the longest serving Ivy League president. Under his leadership, Columbia stands at the very top rank of great research universities, distinguished by comprehensive academic excellence, an innovative approach to global engagement, and this institution's most ambitious campus expansion in more than a century. And he is leading our great university into a new capital campaign, Columbia Commitments, which is dedicated to creating ever more opportunity for students and faculty to make our contribution to our world even greater. President Bollinger is the person who tomorrow at commencement will confer on you, quote, the degree for which you have qualified, unquote. I will recommend you for that degree, but only he can confer it. And you will not actually graduate until he does. So, please give a most hearty and appreciative welcome to President Bollinger.
It was very important that he said that, because I really appreciate it. So I want to just say a few things. I really want to recognize the parents, families, and friends, each of us who go through this every year, each of us who have had children graduate. We really do understand how important this moment is and how much you share in the achievements of your graduates. I also really want to recognize Jim Valentini, who has done such a great job as dean of the college and is a great friend of all of us. Jim, thank you. And David Madigan is, as Jim said, finishing his term as Executive Vice President for Arts and Sciences. His purview is the college, general studies, School of the Arts, the graduate school. He's really done an outstanding job. He cares deeply about the intellectual life of the place, has really nurtured it, and he cares enormously about students. David, thank you very much for all you've done. I have just a few comments today because I speak tomorrow. And I only have so many ideas, so this is it. So this is something that I think you appreciate as you grow older. You realize that what you have lived through is probably the most formative period of your lives. You've been exposed to an enormous range of knowledge and to different ways of thinking. Most importantly, you have been in an environment that takes two things as fundamentally true. One, that ideas really, really matter. Collectively, they form the basis of each of us as individuals and as societies. And two, that there is nothing inevitable about good ideas prevailing over bad ideas. It is only an idea, for example, to take one that I know and care about and you have studied, it is only an idea that there is such a thing as the rule of law that stands above parties, individuals, ideologies. Most countries of the world do not embrace that idea. Indeed, they find it often incomprehensible or counterproductive. Maybe it is wrong. Maybe impossible. The case for it has to be made again and again. Which brings me to the second point. There is nothing inevitable about ideas winning out. The only way that happens is by good people who believe in these ideas, dedicating themselves to seeing that they happen. This has been true in human affairs over and over again. The call of public service is really a call to put into practice in the public realm, the ideas that you have learned in the intellectual realm. Columbia has a centuries-long tradition of faculty, students, and alumni doing exactly that. You are now graduating at a critical moment, a very complex moment in human history. From everything I personally and others have observed about you in the classroom, in debates on campus, in the way you care about issues, the way you've expressed them today, I must say, we are completely confident in sending you out into this world to play the parts of your illustrious predecessors. On behalf of the university, we extend our warmest and most urgent congratulations, and I look forward to seeing you at commencement tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you, President Bollinger. And now it's time. We invite each graduate to the stage for recognition. Advisors from the James H. and Christine Turk Barrick Center for Student Advising, who have supported these students throughout their Columbia careers, have the honor of reading the names of each graduate as they process across the stage to be congratulated by Dean Valentini and President Bollinger. I ask that you please refrain from applause until all members of the class have returned to their seats.
John Philip Avendano, Hannah Bender, Sam Goldberg. Adam Joseph Elkadem. Jia Wan. Umsal Lakani. Kiara Miakalia Ferrari Wong. Crystal Song. Teresa Mensa. Mamfatu Balde. Bindu Bunsinath. Madeline Lee. Brandon Scott Chin. Maria Fernanda Martinez. Aquia Obinga Crofi. Braxton Elias Gunter. David Lee Sierra. Amy Tong. Vicenta Martinez. Larissa Guimaraes. Dylan Jacob Cooper. Madison Rose Gott. Anders Hill. Sophie Louise Bridges. Anastasia Grinberg. Diana Winfield Luber. Alexandra Nicole Pribilla. Catherine Anina Brookman. Heather Cassidy McCumber. Deepti Varathan. Ewan Buell O. Aaron Kaw. Kwakum Winle. Ellen Shefe Guo. Rachel Melanie Makovsky. Danny Yao Lee. Maya Ho. Omar Khan. Nicole Alikak. Nathan Daniel Rosen. Emily Hannah Levine. Alexander Douglas Meschel. Kira Ann LeBron. Sydney Wallace Park. Isaac Talbot Allen. Samuel Coffin. Craig Nielsen. Tatiana Petalina. Yevgen Kanalosh. Felix David Rosenberg. Hannah Montgomery Kramer. Kara Michelle Kupferberg. Edith Comas. Simone Ross Kramer. Rosette Evangeline Zarzer. Ariana Tofti. Liana Paymer. Jordan Alvis Rogers. Sorangel Arlen Liriano. Yannette Rosaria. Yan Lin Wu. Miriam Yasin Dar. Nicholas Lorenzo Tucker. Nayanal Vasquez Garcia. Adam Thomas DeVita. Michelle Rosenberg Zelizny. Giovanni Pagan Velez. Mihao Zyla. Jaden Pantel. Zach David Thomas. Kevin Freefelt. Mitchell Herrera. Maria Christina Frias. Gregory Subong Song. Lubna Kabir. Wen Yi Zhong. Jennifer Fan. Meng Chuan Zhang. Jiamin Zhang. Keming Zhang. Davida Zhang. Harrison Vincent. Samuel Brasharis Collins. Kyle Edward McWright. David Alexander Campbell Swanson. Siddharth Singh. Samuel Ravani. Nicholas Manuel Kensinger. Dominic Luke Shirley. Brian Gao. Jordan Ackerman Goodson. John Marnick Carey. Ryan Christian Chisholm. Peter Kennel Clerger. Lindsay Sue Mendelson. David Scott Mendelson. Samuel Ackerman. Michael Alexander Agnegnos. Timothy Ernest Chung. Miles Jefferson Curry. Michael Gaetano Argenziano. Christian Jacob Ramon. Alexander Lee.
Gary Jiajong Chen. Sarah Newman. Megan Wilcox. Jessica Huey. Isaac Jacob Knudsen. Shawnee Nicole Trailer. Sam Siu. Flannery Grace James. Julia Marie Zay, Briley Lynn Lewis, Juan Pablo Gatica, Leo Stilwell, Karina Robles, Alexa Delgado, Paola Alejandra Piñeros Medina, Aimé Anne Caroline Auguin, Amber Noe, Chang Yung Moon, Sibyl Fares, Sophia Park, Tony Lee, Kate Christensen, Renee Christina Paris, Miranda Veronique Roman, Kristen Gonzalez, William Kweku Esilfi, Joshua Matthew Burton, Lewitt Bedada Gemeda, Jana Kitbalian, Zoe Marie Guy, Willie Victor Coomson, Michael Miley, Baba Abaka Yankson, Oluwayemisi Olorunwunmi, Efwa Peterson, Lorian Ashley Hyde, Marie Saiku, Pauline Emma Morgan, Haley Lane Winstead, Kaylee Wedderburn Pugh, Dina Shearer, Mason Wilfred Eugene Amelot, Christina Paulette Auguste, Victoria Ingram, Charlotte Pierce, Julio Enriquez, Ariana Agrios, Erin Ann Vaughn, Karen Lopez, Alexander Maximilian Burkle, Christian Zaharia, Jennifer Egbebike, Oten Iban, Joshua Zeller, Malene June Nishigaki, Stephen Agai Ali, Victoria Alejandro, Jonathan Shapiro, Margaret Elizabeth Toner, Jan Colon Iban, Rachel Elaine Jimenez, Kelly Maria Powers, Ruchi Kirtikar, Savannah Joy Theodora Anika Irving, Javier Pladeval, Dina Manasherova, Rachel Valentina Summers, Edward Alexandra Kraus, Samantha Gail Klitzman, Scott Sonnenberg, Juan Andres Ellis Ochoa, Nathan Katkin, Shambhavi Tiwari, Rebecca Eve Menashe, Joshua Bernard Sanchez Hovden, Leon Benjamin Villasais Eufrasio, Benjamin Vadimovich Gushin, Robert Gottfried, Sesh Joel Benjamin, Sophia Tepler, Aaron Daniel Amons, Supawat Kongthong, Stephen Leong, Emmanuel Risk, Elizabeth Lucia Gonzalez, Hannah Rebecca Hollandbird, Malia Nazneen Chida, Abby Lee, Anna Chubaiva, Allison Yu, Jennifer Gu, Angela Teresa Vetical, Angela K. Shia, Savannah Wynn Mudd, Zara Ali, Brian Patrick White, Jenna Juliana Lee, Davian Medrano, Liam Nifan McDermott, Charles Hebert, Juan Fernandez Hertzberg,
Emily Grace Morey, Amanda Rose Price, Rachel Aaron Deal, Maeve Connolly Linus, Madeline Rose Meyer, Francesca Garofalo, Sarah Michelle Hoffman, Kevin Wu, Alec Brendan Hun, Joseph Morag, Zachary Robert Davis, Nguyen Chi Dung, Michael Moore, Noah Mavale Miller, Theodore Coyne, Valerie Bushutz, Jean Shushana, Anvita Brad Raja, Anurag Selau, Zoa Ahmad Shahabuddin, Thoasan Bari, Matt Malone, Hannah Pearl Kaplan, Grace Grimm, Lonnie Ray Allen, Mesa Baladi, Ezra R. Aiken Orun, Melissa Ozen, Melanie Bienvenue Richards, Rakabe Tayai Dedesia, Bitsit Halamariam Desalain, Sunchit Jane, Shrishi Sinha, Benjamin Andrew Schoenberg Swanson, Lawrence Grief, Meher Patak, Omid Cohen Sedek, Shamali Biani, Priyanka Mohan Mariwala, Philip John Anastasio, Nathaniel Crawford Jameson, Luna De Buritel, Sarah Chavaringa Rodriguez, Aiden Rivera, Gabriella Rose Dowling, Rosalie Jean Wetzel, Madeline Lily Ehrenberg, Maxwell Paul Feynman, Shriyas Pravin Manahar, Namit Mehta, Adil Rashid Hussein, David John Mock II, Tiffany Poon, Chelsea Miller, Ohima Afori Atta, Bianca Marthlene Joseph, Darren Alonzo Napier, Georgiana Banandana, Kayla Kim, Alexander Gerald Chen, Brendan Moore, Ruben Rui Diaz Pacheco, Richard Harry Niederlander, Isaac Bautista, Jonathan Ebogiai, Richard Yi, Elizabeth Gunawan, Benjamin Anton Lezebnik, Caleb Halverson Freed, Chakyu Jackie Lam, Michael Sheng, Benjamin Patrick Covington, McDaniel John Toos, Barrington Alexander Calvert Jr., Camilo Daria Rivera Vanchirka Coach, Benjamin James Horde, Gloriana Lopez Montealegre, Ross Hunter Chapman, Shoma Chun, Jenny Yeji Yu, Kelly Talim, Caroline J. Chen, In Young Kim, Daniel Elias Bennett, Ethan Scott Adams, Jonah Lee, Christopher Francis Beltrone, Corin Bronsler, David Santiago Goulart Castillos, Ashkadi Kitaya Lloyd, Kathy Persaud, Jason Andre Pearson, Julius Malcolm Gay Wilson, Chidima Ninzerum, Olivia Nicole Parker, Maura Bridget Lynch, Nina Rosalie Mandrakia, Taylor Trout, Titus Willis,
Mitchell Jacob Tuckerman, Thomas Francis Xavier Rooney, Spencer Brian Hake, Aiden Reed Goltra, Ryan Daniel Thomas, Tyler Jeffrey Otterstead, Tal Brody, Dylan Barrett Tarpey, George Miao, Sherelle Liu, Jesse Caleb Ojeda, Jesse Paul Thorson, Rebecca Amira O'Hare, Cindy Liu, Kevin Chow, Amber Officer Narvasa, Nicolas Andres Castro, Sam Velasquez, Rebecca Aurora Arteaga, Abigail Eileen Sharkey, Nell Crosby, Catherine Mead Sammer, Chloe Catherine Hacker, Chloe Camille Benchek,
walking, keep walking.
Sarah Ethel Eunice Helga Heloise Elsinore Hardy. Ellen Melly. Brian Joseph McGovern. Michael Gary McClemens. Maria Andrea Meneses Hirado. Edith Elena Campana. Guadalupe Rogel Sanchez. Kimberly Diana Madrid. Adrian Travieso. Eugene Cha. Lively Ling Tang. Jacqueline Ewen Kong. Yasmin Danielle Bora. Nathan Kelioniani Kennedy Lee. Casey McKenna Kalaloha Apu Takayama. Ifoma Sarah Irobunda. Evan Angelo Hale. Dorothy Janik. Caitlin Marie Hickey. Lindsay Cohen. Alicia Gabriel Schlafman. Caitlin Margaret Cole. Elizabeth Marie Fredrickson. Alexandra Lyons Andreev. Jackie Chung. Zoe Ross. Stephanie Ding. Jillian Rose Segura. Kira Daglio Fine. Andres Solana Roviro. Emre Arslan Tetik. Guillermo Carranza Jordan. Benjamin Jared Praneda. Guy Raber. Leo Prager O'Brien. Richard Min Shin. Ravi Campbell. Wyatt Thompson. Henry Duran. Nicole J. Smith. Sky Grayson. Robin Guo. Anouk Julian Ganegodo. Kabir Leroya. Theodore Zachary Saltzman. Cyrus Cameron Kamshed. Tina Rachel Watson. Kevin Antonio Ruano. Carolina Rabinowitz. Kira Lee Banks. Sebastian Raul Siclay. David Christopher Arredondo. Evan Morris. Isaac Jafar. Charles Jack Furch. Alexa Eve Economakos. Isabel Alexandra Gisolfi. Oriana Marcial. Madeline Laura Lawn. Caroline Harriman. Hannah Manon Simpkin Juja. Charlotte Langen Quail Buck. Caroline Taylor Kaplan. Daniel Reuter. Isaiah Feldman Schwartz. John Alexander Melendez. Henry Francis Litweiler. Sierra Gutierrez Coughlin. Catherine Koch. Cole Alessandro Dunbar. Aliza Silverstein. Alan Lynn. Anisha Dada. Gabriel Swallow.
Scotty Butler. Kelly Laura Martindale. Megan Sarah Grant. Elizabeth Jane Schofi. Lauren Crane. Whitney Gabrielle Hartstone. Rima Asatrain. Emily Grace Kerman. Rebecca Pope. Callie Elizabeth Leahy. Timothy Diavani. Dennis Way. Christy Maria Chung. Megan Wang. Matthew David Phelan. Andres Rivera. Goldie Shen. Jennifer Harchut. Arparwan Wen Viha Vishwa. Karen Minji Cha. Porter Hess Ulgrave. James Russell Brett. Starly Sophia Santos. Vic Ka Poor. John Timothy Maloney. Jessica Oki No. Kira Lily Keen. Samantha Murphy Solano. Nomundari Batdelger. Gurnur Singh Tucker. Tanvir Singh. Trevor Lockhan. Cameron Roane. Kyle Anthony Castlin. Marcus Briscoe. Simeon Spencer. Rafael Antonio Ramirez Jr. Iwoma Oog Buldu. Tyler Jacob Holmes. Colin Adam Earley. Luke Roberts. Thomas Bartholomew Starts. Taronishi Arani. Adrian Eva Shukyuv. Sebastian Starts. Esoa Osarie Meu Meum Robe. Bridget Sophia Tolbert. Christina Nicole Clark. Te Mito Pe Taiwo Kokair. Akni Michelle Bezji On. Michaela Pagone O'Connor. Charlotte Roberta Amelia Silk. Garrett Joseph Ryan. Jacob Noah Maka Lulu Oi. Clayton Emmanuel Potter. Andrew Lawrence Somis. Tyler Pont. Tyler William Zimmer. Tyler William Oberg. Terrell William White. Marcus Henry Scheidel. Matthew Joseph Doggett. Grant Evan Fetchett. Ruka L. Wong. Brooke Bernard Din. Anne Marie Bryan. Thomas Robert Kisak. Julie On Alvo Yano. Nuria Alonso Perez. Ulanu Rose Feldman. Danny Umir Hagdar. Elizabeth Stewart Faith. Tasman Aviva Contour. Luis Enrique Valencia Salazar. Samuel Quinn. Adrian Garza. Frederick Francis Fabiano. Luciana Circusano. Darius Colin Khosrow Shahi. Natasha Louise Porter. Celeste Booth Cliborn. Eduardo Abchuk Kalatlani. Theodore Kleinman. Eugencia Sanchez Medaladia. Monica Penguana. Luis Miguel Acosta Santos. Francisco Fernandez de Ibarra. Stefan Daniel Montez. Hassan Iqbal Ashmil. Thomas Locke Srish. Jonathan Adam Bronstein. Victoria Alvarez Rendwiles. Sinknai Cruz. Alexis Talen Heller. Natalie Jean Gazer. Violet Ivy Victoria. Hunter Lyon. Ruth Waddington. Britt Felsen Parsons. Jonsu Yaiwash Jaiolu. Kaita Greenberg. Mariana Duasnas Lopez. Adeline Brooks Fulton. Catalina Isabel Guerra Ibarra. Alexandra Nicole Silvera. Margot Romano. Ellen Blair Wilson. Brandon Halim. El Oiz Taye. Sydney Elizabeth Wiswell. Jacob Leo Hirsch. Misha Sheck. Nicole Joy Popsko. Kathleen O'Rourke. Kelsey Ibles. Mimi Zimmer. Elise Barber. Maria Matilde Morales. Laura McMullen.
Travis Russell, Alexander Seamus Cody, Cheryl Douglas, Michael Dylan McGorty, Yawana Muwazi Robert Wamala, Chloe Salzman, Logan Page Slater, Jahan Anil Nanji, Marco T. Maitis, Dimitri Borgers, Dante Anthony Guarnerni, Catherine Zhang, Amelie Lasker, Ainsley Katz, Hannah Lindsay, Alistair Pearson, William Samuel Wells Hamilton, Lexi Wong, Sandra Yin, Samuel David Hamilton, Fallon Christina Jung, Craig Buckthorpe, Luke Zahn, Millie Yang, Larissa Ann Mark, Aaron Sampson, James Robertson, Halisha Sunil Chagani, Noah Basri, Ariel Zina Alterweight, Anastasia Ivanov, Jose Carlos Martinez, Annie Sun, Brianna Rose Tate, Justin Robert Woodbridge, Usman Wasim Munir, Thavan Raman Kirschenbaum, Julius Figueroa, Siddhartha Puri, Kanishka Kevlani, Audrey Odette Mukatuff, Hassan L. Tanay, Laura Cadena, Bianca Vivian Brooks, China Brookman, Anish Gawanthe, Devika Kapadia, Marina Bay Hansen, Yasmin Abdel Majid, Seong Yeon Lee, Anthony F. Cruz, Alabusula Anna Akinirunya, Olubumi Adelaran Sulana, Serena Mariki, Jennifer Lay Coates, Jenna Fukudu, Yvonne Lay, Eric Baoye Shu, Stanley Shichin Su, Jay Chi Kim, Sung Moon Yin, Neil Matthew Thivalapil, Julia Camela Rodriguez, Oliver Michael Maria Agger, Jonah Gould, Emily Marasco Dali, Alex Marl, Matthew John Martin, Mia Colleen Matsumotali, Connor Sen Warnick, Wilson Carl Grayton, Samuel Alexander Lane, Elsa Dodds, Nicole Lauren Felmas, Riley Burke, Antonia Georgieva, Larry Lee, Eric Hellstrom, June Mo Chin, Maria Grace Claire Bernadette Escolastica Muratella Mace,
Nicholas Matthew Luber, Daniela Echeverria, Jacqueline Eve Ridgely, Camille S. Shaw, Betty Duran Becerra, Leslie Jane Miranda, Wesley Lee, Bronwen Chan, Hannah Hui Mei Cao, Alan Wang Dai, Mira Davis, Samuel Alexander Hennick, Angelica Rose Tumbas, Spencer Ethan Cohen, Patrick Joseph Flanagan, Alexandra Mariette Fay, Trenda Hunter, Kanako Mori, Prabhyot Kaur Grewal, Alexandra Soloviev, Jin Wu Choi, Anya Malesevich, Jacob Hirsch, Malaya Dominique Sadler, Hamza Taghi, Hijo Kang, Smritri Kanangat, Masi Babagoli, Samuel Weinhardt, Jasmine Pei, Soyoung Chelsea King, Rebecca Landau, Brianne Elise Felsher, Jasper Husong. Simisola Ayomipo Genrola Ibikunle. Ayomide Folasade Ozabamiro. Kiran Akiko Aida. Dragos Konstantin Inyat. Mikhail Rolski. Tayo Hamananaka. Adi Milstein. Fernando Costa Piani Garcia. Hayden Kenneth McGovern. Michael John Fagundo. Samir Wadwani. Lachlan David Nids. Vashish Shriam. Maximilian Peter Bodinger. João Paulo de Mejo Barreto. Noah Harris Thaler. Nels Eric Lindquist. Colin James Conroy. Oliver Burr Jennings. Carlin Cameron Dougherty. Jeffrey Ho. Jeffrey Monahan. Benjamin Till Landis. Gregory Gu. Stephanie Kim. Ayano Case. Minzy Ashley Kim. Ben Zhang. Josefa Diwan. Finn Mundinger. Daniel Navarro. Joseph Rabinovich. Siena Sofia Burkt. Michaela Cavalli. Mitchell Broadwater. Mecca Nasiri. Gabriel Dane Casorla. Jenny Han. Francois Yoshida Ray. Ji Yoon Park. Song Ri. Hudson Lee. Annie Liu. Lauren J. Pan. Nancy Yu. Daisy Miranda Cheng. Grace Elizabeth Brancale. Rebecca Teich. Carolyn C. Benson. Catherine Elizabeth Hernandez. Caitlin Elizabeth Connolly. Kenneth James Spranzo. Raymond Shore. Gabriel Cano. Mark Berghaus. Anise Harby. Kieran Weissert. Anne Drong. Arthur Boswa. Zachary Loha Morant. Sheng Zhan. Dylan Castaneda. Jack Ferris Blattman. Jill Hong. Alexander Christian Bangirl. Rain Margaret Anderson. Talmadge Joseph Wise. James Woodall. Matthew Rivera. Lucas Furtado. Hunter Cook. Madeline Claire Mendel. Sebastian Daniel Matza. Julia Jin Kang. Samuel Lim Kimberg. Emma Rose Lesher Liao. Rebecca Ann Herpin. Michi Mei Isawa. JC Alexa Gaudi. Brian Lee. John Zhang Hui. Karen R. Shea. Hope Chang. Edward Tian. Nicholas Clifford Brown Rhodes. Andre Lee.
Jonathan Zolti. Jonathan David Daludi. Maxim Zwarich. Matthew Ryan. Mihir Gulati. Will Peter Taylor. Aris Stefan Toyas. Peter Fasu Richards. Joseph Matthew Stark. Stephanie Kahigas. Daniel Hong. Thomas Walter Dixon. Wendy Liu. Maria June Sun. James Morrison Rubin. Miranda Fuentes. Claire Drago Klinger. Megan Fuoti Wicks. Tiffany Hu Wong Fung. Rachel Lynn Marie Chin. Talia Rubin. Miranda Davis. Jason Isaac Avigan. David Jonathan Quintus. Benjamin Dubow, Matt Landes, Ezra Jacob Guntovnik, Adine E. Goldstein, Benjamin E. Apfel, Henrietta Astor Catherine Steventon, Kristen Alexandra Santiago, Maya Alisa Burlow, Alessandra Stearns, Connor Davis Yokas, Robert Graham Sheardown, Uwaila Mary Nosa, Maya Imani Collins, Pina Rose Mbogo, Victor Elliott Zaytuni, Ethan Cooper, Gabriel Tzvi Robb, Julian Sant Ryman, Aaron Fisher, Jay Rappaport, Dory Lev Feith, Lisa Hurt, Lauren Elena Haber, Elizabeth Rosen, Yuen He, Jessica Gruenstein, Delilah Wu, Anne Virginia Chen, Gary Baranasam Patanon, Alexandra Boss, Elizabeth Candel, Camilla Van Geen, Charlotte Godu, Evan Hobner, Camille Sanchez, Lucas Solomon, Max Gumbel, Robert Martin Steinberg, Ari Malik, Michael Thurston, Alex Yang, Alex Yu, Garish Chandrasekhar, Matthew Joseph Necky, Anne Chapman Hughes, Ankita Saxena, Amanda Hoy Yan Kam, Silas Kurt Grossburnt, Shiv Gupta, Aquina Sura Bansu, Garrett Donnelly, Warner Laval Jones Brown Jr., Arnold Lee, Alan Cha, Dong Hee Lee, Thomas Liu, Abhinav Sitharamun, Hamza Nadim Mirza, Richard Kennedy, Mikos Legrand, Caroline Thomas Elwood, Madison Pujadas, Natasha Urbani, Kathleen Marie Ryan, Alexa Giuliano, Paige Lee Tippett, Camille Kathleen Zimmerman, Jillian Marie Borison, Nathan Sherwood Hickman,
Anna Chen, Alexia Lay, Kavan Simon Saif Naraji, Jill Shaw, Carlos Martinez, Audrey Brianna Andrews, Kevin Matthew Simpson, Andrew Victor Arditi, Joseph Dominicus Lapp, Benjamin Vanden Heuvel, Michael Herman McGrath Jr., Alexander Burge Holm, Noah Joseph Zagroblich, Patrick Barkley Denny, Benjamin Carter Robbins, Bailey John Popek, Colin Charles Breckenridge, Landon Beatty, Dylan James Weldon, John Paukoon, Bewley M. Wales, Patrick Hagen Patterson, Rafe Omar Ghani, Jack Haney Donahue, Kais Masri, Seth McBool, Hyunwook Lee, Randy Zhang, Frank Zhu, Grant Gregory Paolo, Paul Sungu K, Daniel Lee, Catherine Sue Ponder, Krista L. Cortez, Sienna Ward, Stephanie Ann Fine, Obianuju Enwarom, Osama Khalifa, Saif Ashraf Atiyah, Arum Salim, Maxwell Hu. Mimi Grace Olford Hamburg. Ernest Gregory Washington. Xiomara Bavel. Eleazar Charlie Flores. Christopher Michael Schroer. Ian Tyler. Poe Bowden. Claire Justine Brown. Roya Gisari. Carter Joseph Salas. Justin Alexander Udry. Margarita Malyakova. Nana Olson. Sarah Ying Bai. JP Viernes. Zoe Giselle Grimes. John McLaughlin. Alejandro DeSintz. Tenley Taylor Morning. Nicole Paula Kramer. Seth Harrison Farkas. Caroline Mansour. Elizabeth Einstein. Connor Duke. Brandon Datt. Jamie Ray Withorn. Daniel Almeida Parada. Thomas Eric Nielsen. Nicole Isabel Valencia. Olivia Rose Capel. Irene Nadia Anastasievsky. Trevor Harvey Menders. Sophie Chinchilla. Teo Armislaski. Perry Andrew Kerner. Julia Kim Schluger. Rebecca Will. Ayana Kim White. Kate Louise Wilson. Chantal Marie Sanchez. Callahan Aprilene Meyer. Ganesh Ravichandran. Teresa Cho. Janique Nija Craig. Maha Shaista Ahmed. Shaney Chung. Max Aiden Rosenberg. Ikraz Ikam Nanji. Mona Lisa Joy Okori. Shreyan Reba Shetty. Lane Robinette. Ty Wiest. Zachary Bame. Brett Mason Ganaway. Randall Kenji Kanemaru. Mark Patrick Flynn. Colin Gregory Melrose Francis. Kiara Butler. Victoria Calamares. Kelsey Regina Gayden.
Catherine Marie Cavallo. Nicole Calamares. Sarah Goud. Yvette Portilla. Nurit Futu Kudir. Ian Kaitu. Lana Kaimaish. Catherine Francis Lay. Umre Tha Kor Singh. Brian Kim. Christine Jihe Hong. Danielle Renee Henry. Connor Michael Heeb. Dominic Vasco Perkovic. Reed Michael Stables. Liam Talty. Parker Thomas Tobia. Parker Tomey. David Henry Donovan II. Lord Joshua Hyming. Turner Ellis DeMuth. Jane Abbott. Hayo Enrique Martinez. Karen Melissa Reyes Maldonado. Bradford Maurice Smith. Kian Nu Ren Glover. Simona Serafinovska. Ethan Chi. Mian Timer Sami. Diego A. Dersin. Natalie Ambrose. Maeve Doherty. Carrie Mannion. Caroline Louise Militello. Natalie Nishot. Holly Nishat. Nikhil Dominic. Miles Nathan Lewis. Ayane Haji. Lemlem Baraki. Shisom Onye. Sasha Albillard.
Jacqueline Fuller, Brianna Monique Imani Alston, Chloe Andreo Matthews, Jonah Hempill, John Akumen, Denise Y, Sydney Alexandra Pickens, Leah Samuels, Madeline Jade Levin, Alexandra Van Royen, Alexandra Tabachinokava, Joseph Andrew Falsey, Jorge Mencha Ken, Enroy Lewis, Ricardo Songuilla Barajas, Eva Stanton, Leslie Arlene Chavez Hernandez, Lorenzo Orozco Jr., Amal Mohammed H. Ali, Sadie Evelyn Bennett, Renia Simone Dinkins, Jordan Lee, Kirsten Dodston, Eloiana Marie Rogers, Aminiat Are Afin, Guli Lu Yitseng, Adin Takula Goroso, Mamasu Dakure, Danielle Salagado, Donna Garcia Medel, Melissa Stefania Pineda, Gabriela Stephanie Rios, Jorge Paul Grossman, Aliana Pippis, Mark Jacob Lerner, Anne Lee Steele, Ona Albriora, Sarah R. Sakowitz, Alyssa Kai-Wing Lee, Jing Chen, Rui Lee, Hongru Lo, Zogia Gie, Roa El Tohomi, Zue Na Atig, Omnia Awad Saeed, Sarah Ihabi Kashif, Crystal Espinoza Martinez, Daniel Renee Ruiz Betancourt, Angela Liu, Jasmine Lee Weber, Julia Angelica Maria Mawson, Taylor Nicole Hardy, Keenan Teddy Smith, Nicola Glenn Douglas, Michaela Caitlin Petchel, Uleno Wimberly, Amy Wang,
Paris Michelle Parker Lone, Emily Callison, Carla Jimenez, Emily Joy Fratz, Shivani Pandari, Ji Yoon Olivia Lee, Sydney Rose Peterson, Leon Wu, Danya Hu, Tyler M, Jennifer Kim, Josue David Chavez, Janine Ko, Andrea Konda, Brianna Pereira, Hibaan Charles Seeger, Michael Mayer, Kevin Jun Lee, Mercedes Chien, Kelly Lena Dai, Shasha Lee, David Claflin Newtown, Max Binder, Christine Joanna Dunn, Isabel Forsyth Salahub, Paul Hirschhorn, James Davis, Alyssa Desiree Mendez, Autumn Plumbo, Carolyn Yang, Arif Kaner, Alana Solon, Sophia Lorena Marina, Aaron Javier Jerome, Merrick Razouk, Zoe R.M. Guttenplan, Dennis Namdo Cho, Alex Sangwon Yi, Yuna Rowe, Diana Lee, Juan Ya Feng, Irene Cao, Devin Setyuan, Chris Lay, Jessica Paik, Yi Ji Park, Ashley Kwan, Andrew DeAngelis, Jenny Lee, Swan Wen, Julia Mock, Michael Asali, Anna Paula Viviana Nador Fernandez, Anna Lee, Taylor Kerr, Gabrielle Strauss, Isabel Chun, Yoon Soo Jenna Lee, Daphne Jolie Chow, Nihal Subhas Shetty, Emily Ye, Roma Patel, Boya Wong, Alexander Robertson, George Drimba, Monica Chen, Nancy Xu, Joshua Sa, Sean Wong, Christian Robert Schaff, Alexander Chen Campbell, Peter Daniel Kalitsky, Samantha Carlena Rhodes, Chase Arthur Levitt, John Howe, Brian Cow, Anna Alonzo, Anna Regina Sermon, Margaret Lee Malerny, Alangoya Tezel, Zoe Chopra, Jonathan Udow, Zed Kajani, Pierre Sivan Swinayard, Adam Ali Jamal Sangal, Tanvi Khanna, Shiv Sakhuja, Serene Amar, Nazari Kepra, Justin Alexander Smith.
Please join me in congratulating the class of 2018. We will close these class day exercises with the singing of Sans Souci and Roar Lion Roar, led by the Clefhangers. We invite you to sing along. You will find the lyrics in your program.
Fighting teams again. Hear the lion roar as pride, while the men of morning side follow the blue and white.